Is it safe to consume? Probably not.
Ow, my tummy!
Some people can't handle the heat. Some people live for the burn. If you're Beyonce, you carry a bottle of its sauce around in your bag. No matter how spicy or mild, you're likely one of the over 3 billion people a day who eat this wide spectrum of plants, either raw, cooked, pickled, or powdered. This is the spicy world of peppers. And today, I have my trusty Australian sidekick. We're coming to you live from our living room, and we're about to sample some peppers. Hey, it's Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Florologic. It's hard to imagine a lot of cuisines around the world without the addition of peppers. Be it sweet or spicy, peppers are everywhere and have been for hundreds and even thousands of years. But today, we're gonna play this episode a little differently. As I talk about each of these progressively hotter and hotter peppers, we're going to be eating them for science and regretting ever signing up for this gig.
Peppers are part of the Solanaceae or nightshade family, which includes other delectable members like tomatoes, potatoes, and eggplants. Peppers belong to the genus of Capsacum, which includes 30 genera of peppery plants.
While we think of these as a staple in the veggie department, peppers are actually technically berries. Did you know?
Wouldn't I?
If you're a fan of hot ones, then you've definitely heard of the Scoville Scale, which is used to rank the heat of a pepper. The scale was invented in 1912 by pharmacologist Wilbur Scoville, and it represents the ratio of sugar water the extracted capsaicin needs to be diluted into to no longer be detectable.
The more powerful the capsaicin, the more sugar water you need to not be able to sense it anymore, the higher the Scoville heat unit number. The bell pepper, which is 0 Scovilles, is at the bottom of the scale, and currently the top end is all the way up at 2.69 million. Let's get started with the taste testing. We're gonna start all the way down at the bottom end of the Scoville scale with bell peppers. Depending on where you live, these are sometimes called sweet peppers, capsicums, or they're identified by their color, like red, green, yellow, or orange. They're crunchy, slightly sweet, packed with vitamins A, C, and are a staple on veggie platters and in countless dishes from around the world. Sweet paprika powder is also made from the dried and crushed red variety of this ultra-mild pepper. Shall we?
Yes.
So completely edible.
It can only get better from here.
Nothing bad will happen today.
Most of the peppers we use in cooking are varieties of Capsicum annuum, which has its native range in the tropics and subtropics, ranging from northern South America to southwestern North America. This species, which has both hot and sweet varieties, takes the cake for being one of the most cultivated plants in the world and has become an essential part of cuisines around the globe.
Every day, over a third of the entire Earth's population eats chili peppers. That's more than 3.1 billion people tickling their taste buds daily with these species. And since they cross-pollinate so easily, there are quite literally thousands and thousands of different capsicum varieties to shock your palate. Next up, we have the world's most famous nacho topper, the ever-popular jalapeno. This Capsicum annuum variety clocks in at 2,500 to 8,000 on the Scoville scale. The range is so wide because the heat they pack depends on when they were harvested and the conditions under which they grew. The sooner they're harvested, the less spicy they'll be. So if you're looking for milder jalapenos, look for dark green ones with smooth skin. Lines and shades of red mean they were allowed to ripen longer on the vine and will be spicier. So let's see how spicy these ones are. You wanna take a bite? Should I take a bite?
You first. Oh, that's not bad.
It's not bad, it's totally fine.
There's a little bit of red in there though.
I could eat these all day.
All right, that's pretty good. A little peppery. It's got this like, a little tingle.
Sorry, I may have made a mistake. I may have gotten a little overzealous on the last bite. It's spicier towards the middle.
It warms up like once you eat like most of the seeds.
Doable, not terrible.
Okay.
Remnants of ancient wild Capsicum annuum seeds have been found in caves in Mexico, showing that these peppers have been used by humans for at least 8,000 years. By 6,000 years ago, they were already being cultivated in Mesoamerica. Spanish colonizers brought Capsicum annuum seeds back to Europe in the late 15th century, and from there, trade routes carried peppers to Africa, India, and East Asia.
The name pepper stuck because Europeans of the era said that they were hotter than the pepper of the Caucasus, aka regular old pepper, which was the spiciest thing anyone in Europe had ever tasted up until that point. Next on the chopping block is cayenne pepper, another capsicum annuum variety. Most of you will know this as a dried staple on your spice rack for adding a little powdered pow to your dishes. The Scoville scale for this one is 30,000 to 50,000, so definitely a huge jump from the milder jalapeno. Frank's Red Hot is probably the most recognizable hot sauce made from cayenne peppers. Let's see how this one goes down. Would you care to do it first?
M'lady.
Not bad. I'm okay with it.
I think the jalapeno is a little bit fruitier. That's what kind of like balances things out.
True.
It's like drier, a little bit more pepper.
Verdict is these are totally fine. Just like whatever. So just what is it that makes us feel the heat?
The burn of peppers comes from a chemical compound contained within called capsaicin. This compound causes a burning sensation on the mucous membranes while also upping the production of saliva and stomach acid and stimulating the nerve endings of the skin. Capsaicin gets to work on the nerve cell endings called nociceptors, which are responsible for the feeling of pain. These nociceptors are alarm bells to warn us that something damaging is happening to our bodies.
Since this includes dangerously high temperatures, capsaicin is most often described as a feeling of heat or burning. And that's why your body enters a kind of defense mode when the capsaicin gets too much. Your body's natural cooling system will kick into overdrive and you'll start to sweat as it struggles to fight the burn.
In addition to the scorch it gives to foods, capsaicin is used for a huge range of non-food applications, from pepper spray to arthritis cream.
Next up, we have Thai hot chilies, otherwise known as bird's eye chilies. While all chilies have their roots in Mexico, Central, and South America, this variety is cultivated across Southeast Asia and is used widely in Asian cuisines. These little cuties come out swinging at 50,000 to 100,000 on the Scoville scale. Let's give one a bite.
Yeah.
I feel like because I'm eating like the the
little
ends of it.
What are you scared?
Okay. I am, yes. Okay. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
It's got the pepper. Ooh. It's got the pepper. That's good. Yep. That's good.
There it is. Hallelujah. Well, we surely made a slight jump in Scoville units there. I think I'm sweating. Yeah. It's just building. It's just getting progressively more hot on the mouth. It's really hot. I don't like spice. I don't like spice. Is there ice cream?
Yeah, ice cream's supposedly the only thing that universally gets on hot ones that works.
Okay, thank you. Okay, ice cream wins. Oh, ice cream.
Not all creatures can be taken down by capsaicin like humans can. Birds, for example, lack the receptors to taste it and are completely unaffected. Rodents, however, like people, can have their taste buds absolutely incinerated by spicy chilies. So what is the evolutionary advantage of being able to incapacitate a rodent with a single bite? Studies have shown that when rodents eat chilies, they grind up the seeds with their molars. Birds, on the other hand, swallow and pass the seeds whole, usually far away from the parent plant. So discouraging rodents while appealing to birds helps chilies keep on keeping on.
So why are there chilies that don't produce any spiciness at all? Here, it comes down to an evolutionary trade-off. Simply put, creating these spicy molecules costs the plant a lot of energy, which can be better used elsewhere if conditions are unfavorable. Now we're starting to get into the hotter stuff with our next pepper. This one is actually not a capsicum annuum, but rather a variety of the species Capsicum chinense, otherwise known as habanero type peppers. This is the namesake, the habanero pepper. But there are a number of varieties in this group that will murder your mouth, including the world's hottest chili as of 2023, but we'll get into that later. The Scoville scale places habaneros around 100,000 to 350,000. So we'll see just how much pain that will cause in a second. You go first. Oh, he just took a whole bite. He just went in with a whole bite. Like you just went in. I'm still eating ice cream from the last one.
This has got some spice, that's for sure.
Yeah? You feeling spicy?
Yeah, I do.
Mm-mm.
You don't need to put a little dusting on your ice cream?
No, just like wipe it on my tongue or something.
Just take a nibble.
I mean, that was enough.
Just nibble the flesh, come on. There you go.
Try the red one.
Why?
No, don't get carried away now.
I had my little bite. I had my little heat.
That's actually sweeter.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why does it just keep getting hotter and hotter? I don't don't want that.
It tastes like a cat, it's like regular bell pepper.
You're welcome to it. I would love for you to have that.
Habanero, folks. You're already here first.
I would just love my special cocktail assembled, especially with ingredients that are good for this moment right now.
The one downfall of the Scoville scale is that it's subjective, since it relies on professionally trained testers' taste buds, which can become fatigued with overuse. To compensate for that fact, we also now have high-performance liquid chromatography, which identifies, separates, and quantifies the components in a sample of chilies. Having isolated the capsaicin, its level can be accurately measured. This value is then translated into Scoville heat units, providing an even more accurate rank.
Being half Jamaican, this next pepper is close to my heart, even if it may cause heartburn, the Scotch Bonnet. This one is a close relative of the habanero and ranks about the same on the Scoville scale, at 100,000 to 350,000. It's an absolute staple of Caribbean cuisine. If you've ever had jerk anything, you've had Scotch Bonnets do a jig on your tongue. The fact that it kind of looks like a Scottish Tam O'Shanter hat is how it earned the name, but that is the only thing vaguely Scottish about this pepper. Let's give this one taste for the culture. I feel like you're first. Yeah. How you feeling about it?
It's actually not bad. Yeah, try one of the red ones. Probably a little bit spicier. Nice. Oh, that's a big chunk.
Yeah, look, I bit it. It's really not that bad. Yeah, not bad.
Yeah.
Did you?
I got a good bit.
Should I stop while I'm ahead, or?
Hey, man, go for it. It's fruity and fun, but it's
fruity and fun. You're gonna need some ice cream. This was good. This was good. So, moral of the story is eat about that much, no more, you're fine. Next up we have ghost peppers.
I gotta poop.
Okay, we have temporarily lost Blaise to the washroom because he got Scotch bonneted.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! I'm ready for some peppers now!
Ow! Ow, my tummy! I think my tummy hurts! Ow, my tummy! Pascal, I need my tummy juice! Tummy! Tummy me! We'll just keep this on hand. Okay. Next up we have ghost peppers. This one averages about 1 million on the Scoville scale, which is a huge jump up from the mild by comparison Scotch Bonnet. Ghost peppers are actually a crossbreed of the habanero species Capsicum chinensis and another species called Capsicum frutescens, the most well-known of which are probably piri piri and Tabasco peppers, except that this little pepper here is 170 times hotter than Tabasco sauce. The name ghost pepper doesn't instill me with a lot of confidence, but we're about to try it. You're trying it first. No, you're trying it first. Just take a little nibble. Just, no, smaller than that.
It's not nice.
I took in the tiniest little bite. It's fine. You heard it here first, kids. Ghost peppers are fine. Oh, there it is.
It's like, my one is like deep.
I don't like that. I don't like that.
These guys.
Why did you take such a big bite?
Man, we're meant to do a thing. We're meant to eat the things and then like react to the things. So if you're not taking a bite, then like...
Fine, I'll take a bite. Are you ready? Call me chicken. Woo!
Oh, why is my breath spicy?
Wait, I have to stop breathing and then my tongue will stop being so hot. Very nice. Here, do this. Try this. Peptide.
Oh. I just have to keep my tongue coated in ice cream and then it's fine. I don't like it. Ghost pepper is not the one that I like. I can only think in Scovilles! Wait, can you burp me?
I just burped myself.
That was quite intense. Blaise, can you handle another?
Why?
We can do it. The next and last pepper we've picked from the pack is the Carolina Reaper. In August 2017, the Guinness World Book of Records named this the world's hottest pepper. Also a cultivar of Capsicum chinense, this gnarly little dude packs about 2.2 million Scoville units, or twice that of the ghost pepper that we're still reeling from. Is it safe to consume? Probably not. But we're gonna do this for science, for you. Okay.
You first.
I don't know. I think maybe you first. Just don't take as big a bite as the last time. Come on. Okay, that's quite big, isn't it? What are you doing?
It builds faster than the last one.
It smells spicy. I don't think that I should do it.
Just the littlest nibble for the people.
Oh, yeah.
We should eat maybe more
then? We've eaten enough. It's like spreading around the inside of my mouth.
It's like sharper than the last one, but like...
It's actually getting worse.
That's not nice. That's not nice. That's not nice.
While Blaze is over here reeling from the Carolina Reaper, I'm gonna talk to you about some more peppers. We can't end our episode without touching on the world's current reigning champion for world's hottest pepper, the mysteriously named Pepper X. I can't, my tongue is too sore. We can't end our episode without touching on the world's current reigning champion for world's hottest pepper, the mysteriously named Pepper X, created by Ed Curry, the same chili pepper breeder who came up with this sadistic thing that is still burning my mouth.
Fuck you, Ed.
The Carolina Reaper. Pepper X dethroned his previous creation in August of 2023. This one measures 2.69 million on the Scoville scale and took 10 years to cultivate. It goes without saying that ingesting a Pepper X will cause intense abdominal cramps, not to mention your life may flash before your eyes.
You never warned me.
Blaze, how are you doing?
There is snot everywhere.
There really is snot everywhere. Okay, so what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments below and don't forget to subscribe for new videos every week. And now somebody please get me an adult diaper. She's got to poop. Be it sweet or spicy. Where were you? You wanted to say the spicy.
I thought you didn't want me to
sweet?
Do that because you said it was weird.
Spicy.
You definitely said it was weird.
It's weird to go like this.
Oh, but it was like, you know.
Okay,
like,
doesn't matter.
Okay.
Game show. It's hard.